Hi. Good evening. I'm Fritz Lang. You may remember me for directing such films as Metropolis, Contempt, and The Lucky Ladybug. I really have no idea what to say right now. The director of this show promised me a half bottle of laudanum if I would come out and do something. He really should have tried bribing was Peter Lorre, but, you know, he's dead. But he was a man who would do anything for a half bottle of laudanum. So, this is his story. Not really, it's a story, kind of. So it's for you, the friendless, the disenfranchised, the heartbroken, the abandoned, and the abused. So raise your fists, sing and dance along with the band, and fuck shit up. I'll see you in about 3.5 minutes.
Thank you. through the tale of woe, suffering in faith and insolent pride. Whatsoever word before you go, but I run away and try and hide. Come to the stage with a game of risk. You can say yes, you can, you can only of this. You must obey your attention, you must obey your pick up, and obey the video silver boy. Waving drum, Zeus is around with a bragging tongue. I am an irritable sufferer and amateur. We are hidden in a pool cool. Oh, not up for your face, they all turn the circle. As long as I think you, because an ice does for another week. What?
Might have its full effect upon you, the public. We ask that you drink into insensibility. The artists are top rate. The drinks are top shelf. Bets will be taken at the bar as to the turnout of the plot. And if you don't understand the plot, don't worry. It doesn't make any sense. If all you want to see is something that makes sense, the bathrooms are down the stairs through the lobby and to your left. Just look down. This is a cautionary tale, one of love and trust and believing in fairy dust. Also one how a particular sense of humor may very well get in the way of practical achievement. So we ask you to put your worries outside. Put your common sense wherever it is. People who have common sense put that sort of thing, I really wouldn't know. Raise your hands in the air. And drop out of the old school. Hey! Ho! Hey! Ho!
Well, I dropped out of the old school. Got kicked out of the new school. Got the rumble with some girls from the local art school. Got gone right and off the wall.
Who's that big room? Oh, just got the sugar for spoon food. Got the band with bottles of the rocket fuel.
I couldn't do, I got the idea that I could stay home, 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 home. Well, I've been through all the places, being chased out of bars and stealing on tips of tables, living by my wits, I was not getting by.
Gotta do better living up my head. Just have the sugar with spoonfuls. Come on, man, with bottles of the rocket fuel. That's the idea, what the thing I couldn't do. I got the idea that I could stay home, hey, oh, to keep it at mercy.
Right along, go, right along.
On fools such as me.
Right along, go, right along.
You've never had it so.
Right along, right along.
I'm not saying this to hurt your feelings. You just look at me.
No one's ever hit you in the face of Stanford.
Not like you wear, not like you wear.
Being like a hammer ever is.
I still see you a lesson.
We're strong and as soon as we can, we're gonna get rid of you again.
But even your friends at the art school gonna have to choose.
Hooray!
Thank you. out of bottles and I'll wash your face. Get the idea now, send it to you. You get the idea. Yow, 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 yow.
This is the saddest story that I know. Ladies and gentlemen, Peter Lorre. In this 20th century, where there are more faces than graves to put them in, they found you on the floor beside your bed. Mr. Lorre, mourned by many, but known by few. So few, including myself. But dead is dead. Born Laszlo Lowenstein, 1904, and laid to rest, your ashes in a drawer in Los Angeles. So this is Peter Lorre's 20th century, and it may not be the one you thought you'd find.
That midnight train from Vienna is a bitch, isn't it? Mass transit these days, you never know who you're going to run into. I swear I rode the train all the way in with a Hungarian football team. They tried to do terrible, terrible things to me. Mistreat me in ways I would never describe to such a fine audience such as yourselves. However, for you frequent flyers, a little tip. Razor blades sewn into your lapels when someone tries to grab you, the results are really quite astounding. It's very nice to be in Berlin tonight. Thank you for coming. How's everything up in the cheap seats? I know that actually you had to pay more money to be up there, but you really get what you pay for. You don't have to be down here with the riffraff and the photographers. I wouldn't be so proud of yourselves, however. If there's anybody here without sin, they would have gone home already.
You vowed to sin, leave home a lick in my lips, running stone, the river you spit, cops will you run, in the streets we spine in the world.
burning books, the best part of myself, my own. The concert has begun. Now wherever you do, you're about to sin. Leave home a leg at my lungs. Right in stone, you'll rip me up. Peace, God, will you warn this city? If you wanted to, I'm capable of anything, and so are you. If no one's watching you, I can't help the things I do. Hell, is that true? That never man for himself or against you. And God, the unthinkable can't come true. The world encourages you. Who is watching? Who is guiding you? I am warning you. I believe the unthinkable will come true. And I'm watching you. Every man for himself, all against you. And God takes revenge upon the world. I am trying to take revenge upon the world. I am trying to. Everything will happen just as I predicted. Should I not get finished? I think it can be all the times we run through. I'm a net diving in on you. I think you can tell what I'm telling you. It's more or less true. I think you know what I want you to do. And it's told on you, don't you? Has come true. Just look at you. You are capable of anything, aren't you? I'm so proud of you. You can't help the things you do, can you? Every man for himself, all against you. And God.
Ladies and gentlemen, each week at this time, Peter Lorre brings us the great tales of the strange and unusual, of dark and compelling masterpieces culled from the four corners of world literature. Mystery in the Air, starring Peter Lorre. Brought to you by Camel Cigarettes. Now, radio listeners, experience is the best teacher. And the very best place for that experience is in your very own tea zone. That's tea for taste and tea for throat. See how your throat reacts to Camel's cool, cool mildness. And what your taste has to say about Camel's exotic blend of fine tobaccos from around the globe. Try a Camel. And you, like millions of other satisfied Camel smokers, may well find yourself saying, Camels suit my T-zone to a T. Mystery in the Air, starring Peter Lorre.
Hello, everyone. Well, thank you very much. Thank you for joining me tonight in Mystery in the Air, Tales of the Strange and the Unusual. I have a feeling these tales of the strange and unusual will resonate particularly with you, my audience at home. This next tale is a true story, something that happened to me as a young person. I know you will find it hard to believe that someone as small and unassuming as myself ever had anything strange and unusual happen to them, but I assure that this, you assure you this story is true. I would no more lie to you than I would lie to my own mother. This tale of the strange and the unusual happened to me in a city called Berlin. I know Berlin has had some bad press lately, but when I lived there, it was wonderful. It was nothing but parties and women and loose parties and women with drugs. It was wonderful. And there in Berlin, we used to play a game called Catchy Catchy Beady Uppy. I was playing a lively game of Catchy Catchy Beady Uppy one day, running down the Reeperbahn. So some very nice young gentleman who said that I owed them money. I don't remember owing them money, but I trust people because, as I said, I'm very friendly. And so I just played catchy catchy. I'm not really very competitive. Sports are actually kind of against my very way of living, but I wanted to win this game for some reason. So I went down a back alley and up a fire escape. Up a fire escape and into a window. And in this window, I found just the best party. The music was good, and the girls were pretty, and the booze flowed, and it lasted so very long that soon I was quite incapacitatingly drunk. And so I tried to find my way to the toilet, but there was a line for the toilets, as there is here at this club, I've noticed. And there were people laughing and giggling in the toilet, having a wonderful time, and they would not invite me along for the good time. It made me so very angry. And so I went to the kitchen where I did my filthy business in the sink. I am not proud of what I did, but when a man has to, well, you understand. We're all among adults here. It is 16 and up, after all. So after I wiped my brow, which was sweating profusely, as per usual, I looked over and saw a man sitting at the kitchen table scribbling madly into a notebook. And I thought to myself, what kind of idiot hangs out in the kitchen at a party? What kind of man does not want to hang out with all these beautiful people but be alone and writing? And so I went over to him and I poked him in the shoulder and I said, do you have a Camel cigarette? He said, piss off, you wanker. Somehow this endeared me to him, so I sat down next to him and held my head in my hands in the way I do when I'm feeling a little bit nervous. And I looked down at what he was writing. It was a poem. And, you know, I don't use these words lightly, but this poem touched me in the way I've never been touched by a written word before. His name was Bertolt Brecht. And after this, we became, well, I won't say friends. I would say I just followed him around and he tolerated me. This poem was called Of Poor B.B. I would love to, thank you. It begins, I, Bertolt Brecht, dragged out of the Black Forest by my mother into the asphalt cities so very long ago. I am happy in the asphalt cities. I have every sacrament. I have whiskey. I have cigarettes. I have women who are kind to me. But still the asphalt city stays inside me, cold until I die. I am happy here. I wear a suit because I see you are all wearing suits. And I think to myself, these people all stink. And that also makes me very comfortable because I too have a very particular odor. But still the asphalt city dies inside me every day. We are a fat and lazy generation. We shop and we buy and we buy, and when we return home, we don't know where the money went and we don't know what we've done with it. But still we are happy until we die. But in the earthquakes that are coming, oh, and they are coming, I only have 3 wishes. 1, that I will always have whiskey. 2, that my cigarette will not go out because I sweat so much or because I cry every day. And 3, that I will always have women who are kind to me. I, Bert Helbrecht, dragged out of the Black Forest and into the asphalt cities by my mother so very long ago. Thank you. Somebody. At first I thought you were making fun of me, but you're not making fun of me. That's just the way you are. And my heart left. And my heart left. And my heart left. In my home. If being a dangerous person doesn't pay, one can be perfectly kind from 6,000 miles away. This addiction as close as my stomach. And my heart left. And my heart left. And my heart left. And my heart. I was looking at the lights in these houses, each light cuts a circle from the darkness. Each circle is the center of somebody's life. People spin around these lights like planets spin around the stars. And my heart, laughter. And my heart, left. And my heart, left. And my heart. And my heart, left. And my heart, left. And my heart, left. And my heart, left. Well, my heart leapt, my heart rate certainly leapt, certainly. Other things are the strange and the unusual that happened to me in Berlin. And I know those of you who work in the theater industry will find this particularly strange and unusual, is that I actually found a job. I was appearing in a light comedy about a boy who discovers masturbation for the first time. Which did quite well, Spring's Awakening. Maybe you've heard of it. It brought me to the attention of Herr Director Fritz Lang, who had done some very great stuff beforehand, but he decided to cast me, a comedy actor, in the part of a child murderer. I can only imagine he did this because he didn't like me very much, but more to his personality, he enjoyed disliking me so much that he wanted to see me all the time. Perhaps some of you have similar relationships. He did terrible things to me. He mistreated me in the most inhuman ways. He threw me downstairs. He wouldn't let me sleep. He didn't let me eat. And the worst thing he did to me is he made me very, very famous. Oh, you laugh now, but you don't understand what an inconvenience this is to a shoplifter such as myself. It's terrible trying to get out of Barnes & Noble with a bunch of books when you're famous. Ever since then, I've always wanted to direct, not so much myself, but actually Herr Director Fritz Lang, to visit upon him all the awful things he did to me. After I had left Germany, I heard a story about a particularly uncomfortable incident Herr Director had when he was invited to the office of Joseph Goebbels, who, you know, that little scamp Little Joe, director of propaganda for the Third Reich. It was about a sequel to the film M. He wanted to talk about banning it, but also to offer Herr Director a little deal with the devil.
Ah. Mr. Lang, my dear Mr. Lang, so good to see you. Do you know why you're here?
I guess you're banning my film.
Answer the question!
You're banning my film?
Yes. Your testament of Dr. Mabuse.
Yes.
You know the Führer has seen it, and I have seen it.
And?
No. Terrible. However, we do realize you to be a director of some talent. We see a lot of potential in you. And we'd like you to be the director of the Special Cinematographic Entertainment Operations here at the Ministry of Propaganda.
You want me to work with the Nazis?
Yes. You made the world sympathize with the vampire of Dusseldorf. Certainly you should have no trouble casting a sympathetic light on the Reich.
Mr. Goebbels, I'm very flattered that you should offer me this position. I'm tickled pink, actually, but there's something you should know. I was born and raised a good Catholic boy, yes. However, my grandparents were, you know, Jewish.
Mr. Lang, something you may not realize is that you have no say in your ethnicity. We decide who is Aryan. and who is not?
Well, okay. Appearances to the contrary, Mr. Goebbels, I'm hardly Aryan. I mean, I know I look the part, but truth be told, I'm actually just a half-Lebanese piano player pretending to be an actor, in all truthfulness. I don't even know what I'm doing up here. Some MIT professor asked me to come on stage and play a part of some director, you know, Germany sometime back.
Hey, Raja.
Yeah.
That's actually not in the script.
Stick to the script!
Oh. You hit me in the mouth?
Yep.
How did you do that?
Don't know.
Look, do you know what time the bank closes?
5 p.m.
What time is it now?
5:30.
What?
Yeah. Good. Well, Mr. Lang, we see you Monday morning.
Okay, you know, Lenny Riefenstahl is a hack.
Yes, I imagine that's exactly what happened. But what can I say? The Weimar was such a gas.
Did you get over with your balls? That's off the hook. Sally Bowles, she got a man and he got ripped. Me and my friends have the good ideas, but I swear that don't go so damn well. I got out alive at 35. I don't think I'll ever go back. I remember Paris didn't let me off of the hook. One drink, I'm off the hook. Sally Bowles, did you look at me? She'd say,
oh, you weren't so poor.
There ain't no thing about the promise ring, so you should have stopped some boring. Just a bunch of bullets that I can't stand. I got like a dude, don't spot.
Hey, a pirate in the seat of the bar. Now everybody, what's the hurt? Sally Bowles might help you to call from Jesus down. Don't take a trip from such a tune. We're getting fast, the places I used to play. It's like walking through a minefield every day.
I wonder. Hey, come on, dude.
I'm gonna do it.
I'm a fag, I'm a Jew, how do you do? That's Mr. Anarchist to you. Think it seems dead, shit, man got killed by some dimwit's triumph of the will. All these shows for wet bars, frontline scouts of the culture world. I'm gonna hit you with a dogma on the legs you're in. This is a purely personal thing. As a pirate in there, have no friends, for they came from Sally Bowles, my hand, he got pushed up against the wall. Every time I swing, it's a bang, I spit. Say you're gonna show shit, I mean it. Come if you are in the cattle cars, damn to you do bad, you remember. Oh,
we escape our monsters, and we escape our devils, only to find ourselves in a place where neither monsters nor devils matter anymore. I found myself in a strange land called Hollywood, where all my anti-fascist action got me a job playing a Japanese detective. Why am I Mr. Moto? I so, Mr. Moto. Softly, softly, catchy monkey? Ishi ni. Ishi ni. Ishi ni san shi.
Just can't turn the dirt. sex, so crude and carelessly. And these are just a few of our addictions, but sometimes I say just what you mean.
Welcome to the United States of America. My name is Jack Terrycloth, your friendly INS agent. Here's what you've won: a brand new house, a brand new car, a brand new house for your old wife. Everything that can be yours, my friend, if you only play ball. Welcome to Hollywood, Pete.
What they deserve, not what they demand. Showing up on all the new with cash in hand. Their dreams may light and light may dance. Thrown up against pheromones and romance. And romance. More than anyone else, I blame actors. They're just begging to be in this shit. Don't greedily fucking up culture. Down for a bit fight in a. I grab passion in small comedy. I bet it hurt him bad soon. I small talk in a smaller community. Conflated hopes they finish.
And the cost of arts. You sons of bitches! You thought we would come to this giant theater, be the New York Times, and try and act out Hamlet and make fools of ourselves, didn't you? We know our role. We are the grave diggers. We know it, and we revel in it.
I'm for dry fear!
Fuck!
never one must come to a decision. The Google Lego wheel spinning ticks and decks in the visas.
I'm turning my view high for lifting eyes and through. I said no evil, apologize. The third's not my business, it's their fault now.
Is falling apart, and you want me to make a picture? I'm knowing money, I'm high on bad luck. I guess I'll be around here.
I'm trading my pure heart for little dolls and food. I cannot even apologize. This is not my business, it's their fault now.
And I suppose I've come to a decision. The world is falling apart.
I am making a picture. Treated by your heart.
Oh, little dolls and frills. I cannot even apologize. This hell is not my business. It's our fault now.
Dear jerk face, I mean, dear dad, fondest greetings from me, your daughter. I wanted to talk to you about a couple things, if I can. I know you're busy. But I wanted to first of all let you know how proud I am of you. You know, it's not every girl in the world who can say that her dad is a big Hollywood movie star. In fact, the other day, somebody gave me a $5 bill folded up in the shape of a duck, just because I'm your daughter. It's very special. But I wanted to actually ask you a question. It's quite important. Well, at least it's important to me. Where are you? I feel like I haven't seen you in such a long time. I feel like I don't know anything about you. And you don't know a damn thing about me. I could completely disappear off the face of the planet. I could run halfway across the world and you would have no idea how to even begin looking for me. So I thought maybe we could get together sometime and we could do something fun. We could go to the park and feed birds, or we could make a snowman, or go ice skating, or play cards, or shoot pool, or whatever it is that fathers and daughters do together. I wouldn't know. Well, I also want to ask you another question. It may sound silly, but I thought maybe, can you be proud of me too? Well, I don't know if you'll hear me. I don't know if I'll even ever see you again. And I guess I really don't have anything else to say to you.
We got so high that I couldn't stop crying, and we almost had to cancel the show. And I started to tell someone else's story. I took a bow after it was done.
But I understood it, so it was mine. And yes, you understand it's just fine. Oh, Kathy, I found out what I don't know. Oh, Kathy, Catherine, up on my shoulder, tell me what you see. Kathy, Catherine, can you hear dramatic music? Let's stop this. There is no going home, and yes, of course there is. If you're into the metal, pain it will bring. There is no going home, and yes, of course there is. If you're in the band, it's your thing. The last time you took your death, I'm saying goodbye. So stop, so now this time you know I hate to think twice. Oh, Kathy, I wish I didn't have to go. Oh, Kathy, Catherine, let go of my shoulder, tell me what you see. Kathy, Catherine, can you hear this dramatic music? Where is this? Oh, Kathy, Catherine, let go of my shoulder, tell me what you see. Kathy, Catherine, can you hear this dramatic music? This is our heaven. This is our saying. This is our saying. This is our
Ladies and gentlemen, once again at this time, Camel Cigarettes, yeah, very proud to present Peter Lorre, yeah, Mystery in the Air.
Hello, everybody, and thank you very much for joining me on Mystery in the Air, Tales of the Strange and the Unusual. Hi. Very sorry to tell you this is my last episode of Tales of the Strange and Unusual. The environment here in Los Angeles has become very, very unpleasant. It's not so much the smog, it's the humanity. So as you know, all of California and everyone who lives there, they have a very unpleasant odor. I'm going back to Germany where I've been asked to direct myself, and you know I've always wanted to do that. So for my last piece here on Mystery in the Air, I would like to do my signature piece, that of Hans Beckert, the infamous vampire of Dusseldorf. A child murderer who's been caught not by the police, but by his fellow criminals. Two thugs shoved me violently down the stairs. You bastards! You bunch of bastards! What do you want with me? I turn and stop dead in my tracks. All the members of the underworld stare at me. The entire hall is filled with them. Scum! Crooks and their wives. Prostitutes and their husbands. Pickpockets. Drug dealers. Beggars and drug addicts. And next to them, fans of prostitutes, pickpockets, drug dealers and drug addicts. Most standing, but some still seated up in the cheap seats. And no one moves. They just stare at me. They just stare at me. Like they're looking right through me. I fall to my knees in front of them. Can't you see I can't help what I do? I can't help what I am. And what do all you know? You can't even help yourselves. Maybe you're even proud of what you are. I go home every night and feel terrible about what I've done. You go home and you party and you do more drugs and more prostitutes and more safe cracking. I run endless streets trying to run from something which haunts me always, which keeps me always running, running from something which turns out to be myself. I want to escape, but it's impossible. I have to obey it, and I run endless streets, always, always, and I can't remember anything. And the next day I read what I've done in newspapers, and I think, is that me? Is that me? Did I do that? I can't help what I've done. I can't help it, you see? I can't go on. I can't go on any longer. Please forgive me, ladies and gentlemen. I can't go on any longer.
A commercial makes us die a little bit. Every pop star makes us down, what?
A little bit.
Every new car makes us choke on how little air we get and how we get it. Well, the celebrity makes us filthy a little bit. Every single ad makes us gag a little bit. Every photograph makes us rage. Each sound that tells us, each sales of them condemned. Talk about love, you wanna tell me
what I got?
You're about to give it to me.
I won!
I win a lot. You're not happy, and no one gives a shit. This is a game and you battle idiots. Maybe it's time for you to quit.
Because every car you buy, it's a born baby Jesus Christ.
Not the boss, so it's good for him, for you, for me. Not good for everybody, all right. Give me your coins and I'll spin them away one by one. You wanna give me the chips, you know I'll play them for the game has begun. And no one is happy, and no one gives a damn. No one can tell me who I am. I'm wiggle, 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 right, yeah.
Because every new car you buy,
it makes a poor baby Jesus cry. Nothing for souls good for him, for you, for me. Nothing for anybody dig this.
Just wanna
kick your ass.
nothing for souls good for posterity that is not laid at this party. No way.
That noise? Who could possibly be knocking at my door at this time in the morning? I don't think it... Leopold, did you invite someone over? Oh, very well, Leopold. You're clearly high on drugs. I'll get the door myself. Yes, what can I do for you? Hello, hello.
Hello, Mr. Lorry.
Yes.
Hello, my name is Mike. Hey, one second. Damn it. Ah. My name is Mike from the Federal Bureau of Investigation. A couple of routine questions for you. Just very routine.
Could you come back later? I work in the evenings. I'm very, very tired.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry to bother you at home in your dressing gown, sir, but just a few routine questions. Peter, is your given name your Christian name?
I don't have a Christian name, and what kind of fool be named Peter in the first place?
Really? Let's see. Hang on.
Look, I'm really
Are you
busy.
Now or have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
I don't go to parties anymore. I'm far too busy. I prefer to stay home and sleep.
Thank you, sir. Friends of yours, acquaintances, past and present or otherwise, who may or may not have been allegated to be agitators, sympathizers, agents, or agitators for the Communist Party or other red agencies?
Of course my friends were sympathetic, otherwise they wouldn't be friends with me. And as far as agitators,
Tab
I don't
Hunter.
Really bother with them. I beg your pardon?
Tab Hunter?
Tab Hunter? Look, it's very, very early in the morning, and if you're not gonna come in, then I'd have to ask you to leave.
Richard Gere?
I now support Mao Zedong and his effort to take over Tibet. I would like to go home, please.
Sir, have you ever, it says here in my file here, I'm sorry, pardon me while I turn page, it says here that you're a known consumer and advocate of controlled illicit substances emanating from the Far East, including opiates. Is that true or is it not true, sir?
Only thing I'm addicted to is bad ideas.
Oh, really?
I was a prince, now I'm so broken, so the bad ideas and the drugs and the love, the beauty in this world I know. Always a monster, I was a saint, now forgotten, so addicted to bad ideas and the blood that all runs from my eyes and my arms and my throat.
cause I can. Cause no one can stop me, cause it makes up the things I lost. Because I'm addicted to bad ideas and all the beauty in this world. Cause I can, no one can stop me, cause it makes up the things I lost. Cause I'm addicted to bad ideas and all the beauty in this world. Cause I can, no one can stop me, cause it makes up the things I lost. Cause I'm addicted to bad ideas and all the beauty in this world.
Cause I can, no one can stop me,
cause it makes up the things I love. Cause I'm addicted to the bad ideas
and all the beauty in this world.
I can't remember that 1 September on the frontiers through which I crept. Well, the displaced we forget, but the dope and the one in the park. Oh, hell, it was a ride. What a wonderful, 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 wonderful. It's hard to remember any December. It just seemed I was always leaving. Maybe you know that feeling. I never forgot my lines.
All my lines.
I hear them all the time.
Time,
what
a wonderful,
wonderful, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Wonderful, 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 wonderful.